I'm Anil Kumar, sharing with you solution of curve sketching for a polynomial function. We need to sketch graph of f of x equals to x squared plus 16 over x squared minus 8. So from this, one thing is very clear that we do have a vertical asymptote at x equals to 0, right? So from this data, we know x is not equal to 0, and we do have a vertical asymptote at x equals to 0. Correct. Now let's try to find other things about the function. One of them is whether the function is even or odd. So we'll test for even and odd. The test is you have to find what is f of minus x. Replacing x with minus x, we get minus x whole square plus 16 over minus x whole square minus 8, and that gives you, all these things will become positive, so we will get x square plus 16 over x square minus 8, which is same as f of x, and that means the function is even, right? So what we have got here is that since f of x is equals to f of minus x, the function is even. So even function means it is symmetric about y-axis, right? So it is symmetric about y-axis. Now let's see if we have some local maxima or minima. For that, we'll find the derivative of the function. So let's test for local maximin. So for that, we'll analyze the first derivative. Function given to us is f of x, derivative f dash x will be 2x. Here the derivative will be minus 16 times 2 over x cube, and that is 0. So we could now take a common denominator of, we can take 2 as the common denominator here, and x cube. So if I take x cube in the denominator, I get x to the power of 4, and 2 I've already taken, so minus 16, correct. Now we can find the critical numbers for the function. X equals to 0 is one critical number, and the others from this expression. So let's factor this further. So we have 2 over x cube, and that gives you x squared minus 4 times x squared plus 4. Okay, so what are the critical numbers? So that gives critical numbers as 2x equals to 0 when it is undefined, and that gives you 2 critical numbers, plus minus 2. So these are the 3 critical numbers for us. What we can do now is test at which point it is maximum and which point it is minimum. For that, let's find the second derivative. So the second derivative for the function is, this is an easy equation to factor, so we'll follow that one. Derivative of 2x is 2, and here we have 32, so that minus becomes plus now. Let me write 32 times 3 x to the power of 4, correct? Okay. Now, for plus or minus 2, well, it is not defined for 0, okay? It makes sense. That's a vertical asymptote. So for both plus and minus 2, what we have here is positive. So what we find is that the second derivative for plus minus 2 is greater than 0. So when it is greater than 0, then we have a local minimum. Correct? The graph of the function at this point will be kind of concave up, correct? So giving you a minimum. So let's summarize what we have learned. So what we have found here is that we have local minimum at minus 2. So if I substitute minus 2, I should calculate the value first. Okay, let's find out. Both becomes positive 4. So let me write down f of plus and minus 2 equals 2. So when I write here, so we get 2 squared is 4, 4 plus 16 over 4 minus 8. 16 over 4 is 4, so we get it 0. Correct. So it is 0. So at minus 2, we have 0. And at plus 2 also, the value is 0. It makes sense because the function is also even, correct? So that gets linked. Okay. So till now, what we have learned is that we have two local minimums, one at minus 2, the other one here, and we do have a vertical asymptote. Now, how will the function look like? What we could do is, we could also factor the function and see how it looks like. So let's rework on the function itself, which is f of x equals to x squared plus 8, 16 over x squared minus 8, right? So let's do that rework, which I could have done earlier before all this also. So I'm rewriting my function f of x as equal to, if I take x squared common in the denominator, then I get x to the power of 4 plus 16 minus 8x to the power of 2. So that is, I could write this as x to the power of 4 minus 8x squared plus 16 over x squared. Now this becomes a perfect square with x squared minus 4 whole square, right? That becomes the numerator. Denominator is x squared. So that gives you an idea that this function is always positive. Do you see that? So what we see here is this function is always positive, which is greater than equal to 0, since it is 0 at plus minus 2, right? And now we have two roots here, right? We have two roots here. Those are at plus minus 2, and that clearly indicates that, let me rewrite this as x, let me write like this as x plus 2 times x minus 2 whole square. Let's write like this, over x square. Now it becomes very clear, both the roots are squared, right? So they are always positive, and therefore the function will look like this. So that is how the function will be. This is minus 2 and that is 2. So I hope this analysis helps you to understand how to sketch such polynomial functions. You can write down now the intervals of increasing and decreasing and domain and range for the given function also. I hope that helps. Feel free to post your comments, share my videos with your friends, and if you like, that'd be great. Thank you and all the best.